Am I as a TAMU is more inclined towards management rather than technical. If you take MIS at other universities, there's a lot of data analysis and technical subjects, but Texas A&M is more focused on a management perspective. So it will be more of documentation. Texas A&M is like, it helps you to look at a bigger picture when it comes to some like project management, and that's how they train you. So the Texas A&M curriculum is quite rigid. So the first two semesters, you just like, they have already set up the courses and you attend the courses. You don't have a choice. The next two semesters, the second year actually, you have out of the three courses, you can elect two courses. One is a fixed course. So for the first year so far, it was Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, and two lectures on one day and one lecture on one day, 8 a.m. class. It all depends on which cohort you got get. Course for spring is an online course. There are 36 credit hours in total, and 12 courses. You have to do 12 courses, and the 8 courses are fixed. So the first three, the first 6 courses for the first year, those are fixed, and 2 courses per semester for the second year, those are fixed. MIS doesn't have a specialization, so you choose what course you want, and on that basis you can say that's your specialization. Of all the courses on the university website, so you can go through that. Some courses there, like, it all depends on which department you are going to. When it comes to elective courses, they do mention that you have to contact the department. Yes, there's an entire list. So ISTM is ISTM and SCMT. Those are the initials that we, the MIS administrators, they control. So when you select one of those courses, there's no issue. There's no checking out the requirement, prerequisites and stuff like that. But when you go to a computer science engineering course, because MIS is in business school and that's a whole different thing than the engineering school. So they have their own requirements. They actually give like a list, like, this is the requirement that you need to fulfill, otherwise you don't get in the course. I don't think I've heard something like that happening, because business school is completely different and I'm not sure about it, obviously. But yeah, the projects and the coursework, I would say it's not that demanding. You can easily complete all of it. It's just continuous work. So you can't say that this week I'm not going to do anything, I'm going to just kick back and relax. 2 hours of concentrated work and you're done for the day. Managing a good GPA in MIS, I would say it's quite easy. It's not that difficult. Companies have a requirement for applying also, so you need a good GPA for that. Other than that, it's all about your knowledge. If you can get in, you can get in. MIS has a huge summer program, which they call the students over here if they think that the students are not prepared for the coming up course. So generally, if they feel like you're not prepared for the degree program, then they will call you for the summer before the fall. If you come from a non-technical background, I would suggest you learn SQL, you learn some of the basics like Python, C++, something like that. I mean, if you have work experience in that particular area, I don't think they will call you here. And if you don't have experience, but you're from a non-technical, let's say you're from EC or something like that, they would ask you like a coursework from your bachelor's to show that, okay, you have done something with database and this is what the curriculum was.